One night, at the height of the French Revolution, three drunken soldiers set out to test the legend.
Toutes ces bonnes femmes du Durand. Allez, sors-moi d'ici. J'en ai assez.
Allez, monte.
Laisse entrer travailler un peu.
Non, non, non. Nous, c'est suffire.
D'accord.
Un peu
bon,
voile
on
cercle.
Peut le sortir.
Prends la lanterne.
Je vous laisse.
Allez, tu ne soulèves pas.
Ça y est.
Je viens. Je viens.
It was not the skeleton that suddenly sobered the soldiers, but the plaque around its neck with the date May 1791, which could only have been placed there at the time of burial in 1566. Nostradamus had predicted 200 years before the exact date when his body would be dug up.
Santé!
Non, Robert, tu peux pas. Oublie.
The shot that killed that soldier was fired from the riot of the surrounding revolution. A stray bullet, a freak accident that fulfilled the legend of Nostradamus. Nostradamus. What kind of a man was he who predicted the date of the desecration of his own grave, whose predictions were used as propaganda during World War II? A man who has accurately predicted events over the last 400 years, from the French Revolution to the Kennedys, and on into the future, even to a Third World War, and eventually the total destruction of the world as we know it. What then are we to make of his predictions? If they're true of the past, what of the future? Tonight, we would like to introduce you to the prophecies of Nostradamus. Well, that was 10 years ago when we first introduced television audiences to the prophecies of Nostradamus. Then, the name Nostradamus was hardly known. Today, it's familiar to most of us, and its significance, of course, varies. To some, Nostradamus, or any form of prophecy, is just a joke. Others, by extreme, take it all too seriously. But for most of us, there is something about the writings of this man that make us at least wonder. There always seems to be some new occurrence that reminds us of his prophecy, a reflection of his accuracy that intrigues and frightens us. And it's this accuracy that we must each individually assess. For if there is enough truth in what he saw of our past, then it's perhaps worth considering what he says of our future. So, with this in mind, and with the benefit of hindsight, let us now revisit and reconsider the prophecies of Nostradamus.
Desecration of his grave in 1791, the remains of Nostradamus were transferred and buried here in the wall of the church at Salon. This, his final resting place, is only 40 kilometers from the small village of Saint-Remy de Provence, where he was born in the year 1503. His ancestry was Jewish, but his immediate family had converted to Christianity. Although his father was a doctor, they led a simple life in this small house, nestling in the shadow of the church. His grandfather, also a doctor, began to educate him at an early age in medicine and the classics, and also in the ancient science of the stars, astrology. From this rich heritage of learning, Nostradamus moved on to study medicine at the world-famous University of Montpellier. He graduated at the age of 22 and was immediately involved in the struggle against the plague, then sweeping Europe. His fame as a healer soon spread due to the success of his simple yet unorthodox treatment of clean air and unpolluted water. However, his own wife and two daughters fell victim to the plague, and Nostradamus was left alone. He wandered aimlessly through Europe, and although he continued to practice medicine, his attention turned more and more to the study of astrology. It was during this time that Nostradamus first began to experience his visions of the future. He returned to the south of France and settled in the small town of Salon, where he remarried and made his permanent home. In the seclusion of his study, he began to record his amazing visions and commenced what was to become his life's major work.
Seated at night in my secret study, alone, reposing over the brass tripod, a slender flame leaps out of the solitude, making me pronounce that which is not in vain. Divining rod in hand is put in the middle of the branches, with water moisten the limb and the foot, struggling fear, sleeves trembling, heavenly splendor. The divine seats himself nearby.
His writings clearly show that Nostradamus was both able to see and to hear these events, almost as if he were present in some future time. Was this the work of God or of the devil? For this was the age of witchcraft. The 16th century was a time when superstition made men strike out at the unusual, the odd, and the eccentric. And countless innocent people were tried, convicted, and sentenced to horrible tortures and death. For such a man, for any man, to announce predictions now tumbling before him was to invite disaster. So Nostradamus began to write down his predictions in such a way that they would be preserved for posterity and survive fear, suspicion, and destruction through ignorance. He chose a four-lined rhyming verse known as the quatrain. Writing in his native French, he confused the verse with Latin, Greek, and even anagrams. So the truth would have to be unraveled, interpreted, and deciphered. He wrote 1,000 quatrains, dividing them into 10 groups of 100 each, called centuries. One half of the quatrains have already come true, nearly 100 of them in recent times. Some are too obscure even for today's scholars. Four, as a final precaution, Nostradamus threw his predictions into the air, and by compiling them in the order in which they fell, completely confused the chronological order of events. Only then did he consider it safe to publish. His precautions have been rewarded in that his book is one of the few to remain constantly in print since it was first published in the 16th century.
His first edition of 350 quatrains was published 2 years before his death, in 1564. He was immediately summoned before the court of King Henry II because in one of the published quatrains, he wrote, "The young lion will overcome the old one on the battlefield in single combat." In a cage of gold, his eyes will be put out. Two wounds in one, then to die a cruel death. This was the 35th quatrain of the first century, which suggested that the old lion, King Henry, would die in a tournament. The king said that it was ridiculous, that he would never joust and would always protect himself against such a wound. Nostradamus replied that his predictions offered fates that could be avoided, destinies that could be diverted. But soon after, there was a unique double wedding of the daughters of the king, and part of the celebrations was the staging of a tournament in which the king determined to take part. Reminded of the prophecy, he insisted that he would fight in single combat, but that he would wear a protective gold helmet.
The young lion will overcome the old one.
The young lion was Count Gabriel de Montgomery.
On the battlefield in single combat.
Despite the attempts of the young count to refuse the match, they met in the safest possible combat. Wearing a gold helmet, no lance could possibly penetrate to inflict the injury predicted.
In a cage of gold, his eyes will be put out.
As they came together, the lance of the young count hit the king's chest, splintered and jabbed up under the protective visor.
Two wounds in one.
The splintered shaft penetrated through the eye and into the brain, and it took the king some 10 days to die in terrible agony.
Then to die a cruel death.
You get a warranty. The best used car, only one place to get her. This is Best Buy's, no one helps you better. Walk this way.
Change you make.
Making me some changes.
Now, if you can get hold of some boiling water, Huey's have a great new range of delicious noodles made here in Australia from authentic Chinese recipes. Huey's 1 minute noodles and Sui Min Chinese meals in a cup. Just put the 1 minute noodles into boiling water. Or, for a delicious snack, pour boiling water into a cup of Sui Min. Three authentic Chinese one-minute noodle flavors and six varieties of Sui Min meals in a cup. As easy to make as boiling water.
Oh, oh, they're going to be here in 10 minutes.
What are you going to do now?
Give me the fine book.
You can't cook that.
It's not ready yet.
Again?
You ready? Coming.
Two all beef patty special sauce.
There's cheese, pickles, onions.
It's on a sesame seed bun.
2枚のミートにレタスにチーズ.
Two all beef patty special sauce. There's cheese.
雙重牛肉巨無花.
Sauce special, la tuga por mayo.
2 lagen eines Rindfleisch, Spezial sauce.
Creme, this is 3 loaves of Maggie Mr. Sunny.
Buy a Big Mac now from your McDonald's store.
And get a hot apple pie just 30 cents more.
A hot apple pie just 30 cents more.
At McDonald's.
When Raquel Welch is washed up on a desert island, the first thing she does is find a forest pool and get her gear off. Pity about the only other inhabitant, Jack Thompson, a boozing, girl-chasing Aussie layabout who thinks he's in paradise. Can can Jumpin' Jack melt her icy heart?
I love her when you walk like that.
Of course he can, in the sexiest desert island romp since Blue Lagoon. Trouble in Paradise, for the first time on television, Monday on 7.
The blood of the just shall be dry in London, burnt by the fire of 3 times 20 and 6.
This is the first prediction to come true after the death of Nostradamus, in which he predicts the Great Fire of London and accurately gives the date, 3 times 20 and 6, 1666, a prediction he made 100 years before the event. Erica Cheatham, authoress of the current best-selling book on Nostradamus, has devoted most of her life to the study of his prophecies.
He writes of the Great Fire, and he also writes in the fire, the extraordinary story was that a lot of people ran to St. Paul's Church for sanctuary, hoping that that would protect them from the fire in London. And the statue of the Virgin on the porch with the heat cracked and toppled down. And he talks of the Virgin who falls and crashes.
The ancient dame shall fall. Of the same sect, many shall be killed. For the future, idiots without heads.
No doubt the event that distressed Nostradamus most, being French, was the revolution beginning in 1789.
Despite the king, the coin will be brought lower. The people shall rise against their king. Peace being made, holy laws made worse. Paris was never in such great disorder.
It must have caused him great pain to see the turmoil that was about to befall his beloved France. Yet, with amazing clarity, he predicted events about which he could have had no inkling. Charles Neilson Gatti, author of They Saw Tomorrow, which includes many prophets, but concentrates strongly on the works of Nostradamus.
Whether they were true or not, after the event, a conspicuous example, I think, of this, is the famous verse in which he says that the first elected king of France, which Louis XVI was, would be stopped with his queen, noted for the color white, which Marie Antoinette was, at a village called Varennes in the north of France, and taken back to Paris, the capital, to be executed by a new form of death, which is, of course, remarkable. 1555, that came about. In 1791, he was foretelling not only the actual name of the place, Varennes, but also the bringing into being of the guillotine.
Another example, the advent of the jury system.
The reign taken, the king will conspire. The lady taken to death by those sworn by lot.
Those sworn by a lot, a jury.
The life of the queen's son will be denied, and the concubine suffers the same as the wife.
The lady taken to death, Marie Antoinette, and the concubine, Madame du Barry.
The West shall be freed of the British Isles.
Nostradamus wrote about revolution in all countries. For example, the American War of Independence.
The eldest sister of the Britannic Islands shall be born 15 years before her brother, by what is promised her and by help of truth. She shall succeed in the Kingdom of Balance.
The eldest sister of the Britannic Island shall be born 15 years before her brother. This remarkable prediction not only accurately suggests that America, the eldest sister, will achieve independence before France, her brother, but actually stipulates the gap of 15 years between the beginnings of the Republic in each country. America in 1776, France in 1791. Exactly 15 years. And he goes on.
By what is promised her, and by help of truth, she shall succeed in the kingdom of balance.
The kingdom of balance. This indicates that the Republic of the United States will ensure balance and peace in the world. And there is no doubt that the United States has fulfilled that prediction.
Comrade Red Guardsman, I greet you as the first heroic volunteers of the Socialist Army, which is the basis of a strong revolutionary army, which will defend what we have achieved through revolution, our own Soviet power. Justice is on our side. Victory is certain.
The Russian Revolution of 1917.
The realm left to two, they will hold it very briefly. 3 years, 7 months will pass in making war. The two Vestals will rebel in opposition. Victor, the latest born in the land of Armenia.
Lenin and Trotsky attained power in November 1917. They did not continue the war with Germany for long, but concluded a separate peace in March 1918. Exactly 3 years and 7 months after the beginning of the war.
The two Vestals will rebel in opposition.
After the death of Lenin in 1924, Trotsky and Stalin became rivals.
Victor, the latest born in the land of Armenia.
Stalin emerged the victor. He was the younger man, born in Georgia as we know it. But in the day of Nostradamus, Georgia was part of Armenia.
One of the greatest shall flee into Spain, which after shall cause a wound to bleed long, leading armies over high mountains, destroying all, afterwards shall reign in peace.
Here, Nostradamus refers to the long war in Spain, after which he says, they shall reign in peace, which is exactly what happened. Because after the establishment of the Franco regime in 1938, Spain remained neutral during World War II. But he went even further. In another quatrain, he actually names Franco.
From Spanish Franco shall come the assembly. The ambassador not pleased shall make a separation. Those of the Riviera shall be in the struggle and shall deny entry into the great Gulf. From Spanish Franco.
But this is not the only real name Nostradamus wrote. In Century 1, Quatrain 25, he says, the lost thing is discovered, hidden for many centuries. Pasteur will be celebrated as a demigod when the moon completes her great cycle. Here he clearly names Louis Pasteur and refers to his introduction of sterilization in 1889, the exact year that the cycle of the moon was completed. Pasteur the scientist and Franco the leader, both named by Nostradamus in the 1500s. But he speaks of many leaders. Some he calls antichrists, a description not just of the men, but of the movements they lead against peace and Christian principles. He refers to three antichrists. The first was Napoleon, the second Hitler, and the third yet to come.
Sugar. It's as natural as
hello sunshine, nature shining through. the sugar cane, bringing that great taste back again. Hello, sunshine.
Hello, sunshine.
A natural warmth shining through. Sugar's energy from the sun to you. Hello, sunshine. Hello, sunshine. Hello, sunshine. You're a natural part of life. Hello, sunshine. Hello, sunshine. Hello, sunshine. You're a natural part of life.
Sugar, it's as natural as sunshine.
Hello, sunshine.
Researching the facts, and the clinical tests prove there isn't a pain reliever more gentle to the stomach than Panadol. Panadol from Winthrop has pure paracetamol, so Panadol provides effective relief from headache, pain, and fever. And you know you can trust it. But remember, always use Panadol only as directed, and please see your doctor if pain persists.
The Best and Less Father's Day sale is packed with special gifts for Dad for under $10. Just take a look at our shirts and shorts. $9.99 for 100% cotton fashion shorts. Ruggers and Iron Man shorts, $9.99. Still only $9.99 for shirts and a huge selection, some boxed, just for giving. At $9.99, it is a gift. So remember, Dad, and remember Best and Less.
Get set for the adventure of a lifetime. Gus McCrae.
Now besides the whiskey, I think we'll require a little respect.
Captain Call.
I hate rude behavior in a man. You get back, won't tolerate it.
Two lawmen.
She was the most famous Texas Rangers that ever lived. You know that?
Who won't say die.
It ain't dying I'm talking about. It's living.
Their story begins soon on the 7 Network. Lonesome Dove.
Will be born near Italy, one who will cost his empire quite high a price. They will say that with such people as rally round him, he will be found less prince than butcher.
This was the first use of the word emperor in association with France. Not only did Nostradamus, living in an age of kings, have to predict their disappearance, but that such a man as Napoleon would take for himself that august title, emperor. And to be born near Italy, in Corsica, was unheard of for a French ruler.
From a simple soldier, he will attain to empire. From a short robe, he will attain the long. Great swarms of bees will arise, such that nobody will know whence they've come.
This is an excellent example of both his accuracy and the clever way in which Nostradamus hid his true meaning. The reference to great swarms of bees would have had very little significance until 1799, the year Napoleon, as emperor, adopted the beehive as his crest.
For 14 years, he will hold the tyranny.
Napoleon's length of reign, from the day he overthrew the Directory, on November the 9th, 1799, to April the 13th, 1814, was 14 years and 5 months.
A great troop gathered shall come from Russia. The destroyer shall ruin a city.
The name Napoleon is Greek for the new destroyer, and Nostradamus predicts the abortive attack against Russia and the beginning of the downfall of Napoleon.
The rear guard will make defense, but the exhausted ones will die in the White Territory. The deepest part of the west of Europe, from poor people, a young child shall be born who, with his tongue, shall seduce many people.
Neurosis, charlatanism, bombast, anti-socialism, hate of the Jews, treachery, murder, race insanity. I am the leader of the German people!
The great squawker, proud without shame, shall be elected governor of the army. They shall pursue crosses of iron, topsy-turvy. Under the feigned shadow of freeing people from slavery, he shall usurp the people and city for himself. He shall do worse by the deceit of a young whore, for he shall be betrayed in the field, reading a false poem.
It reads like a Grimm's fairy tale until you remember how hideously real it all was. There's no denying these quatrains vividly describe Hitler and the Third Reich, and they stand as a classic example of how clear his cryptic writings become after the event.
The third premier, worse than ever did Nero, see the spilling of brave human blood. He shall cause the furnace to be rebuilt. Brothers and sisters shall be slaves in various places. They shall go in heaviness, witness their chin, forehead, and nose. The bloody emperor by battle shall make a speech and roast the tongue, the flesh, and the bones. They shall think to have seen the sun in the night when the hog, half a man, shall be seen. Noise, singing, battles in the sky shall be perceived, and brute beasts shall be heard to speak.
Here is another example of how the prophecy only becomes clear after the event. It could be said that Nostradamus himself does not quite understand what he is seeing here. It would be difficult to conceive in 1560 that one day man would fly and wear oxygen masks. So he describes the vision, half hog, half a man.
Take cover!
Shall be seen. Noise, singing, battles in the sky shall be perceived. And brute beasts shall be heard to speak.
The beasts heard to speak is the radio talkback, and battles in the sky we now know too well.
In the islands shall shall be such horrible tumults that nothing shall be heard by a warlike surprise. So great shall be the assault of the robbers that everyone shall shelter himself under the great line.
Another hidden meaning.
There's a remarkable verse in which he implies that the whole population of London will take refuge in the great line under the city, which of course is a very good description of the London Underground. And he says that living fire in globes will descend upon the city and light it up so that it can be destroyed. It seems almost as though he had an indication of what incendiaries would be like and what their use would be to light up the target for the bombers.
By night the fleet shall shoot against the city. The city shall be on fire, the enemy shall be favorable to it.
As well as seeing planes and bombing, Nostradamus also describes ships and even army ducks.
When the fish that is both terrestrial and aquatic by a strong wave shall be cast upon the shore.
Nostradamus casts his net wide. There hardly seems an event not touched by his distant probe. He saw all aspects of war, but he also saw peace.
The scourge being past, the world shall be made smaller. Peace for a long time. Everyone shall go safely by air, land, and sea. And then... he will come to take himself to the corner of Luna, where he will be taken and placed on a strange land.
This quatrain, referring to man's walk on the moon, Nostradamus goes further to talk about the space race and its attendant tragedies.
The unripe fruit shall cause great scandal, great blame.
During the space race, both the Americans and the Russians lost lives in accidents, in many cases attributed to the rush to launch men into space prematurely. As Nostradamus so aptly puts it, the unripe fruit. But as well as the failure, Nostradamus also saw the success.
Great blame. To the other, great praise.
Thank you. What vision? What prophecy? Not only to see the future as played out on Earth, but also in space. Some 400 years before the event.
Presenting a classic story of love and desire, starring a superb new selection of best-loved soft and hard centers in sumptuous milk and dark chocolate, the Valentino Collection. New from Red Tulip, the Valentino Collection for great chocolate lovers.
It's always been a battle, getting kids to clean their teeth. Now there's some great tasting ammunition. Aim Fresh Mint. Aim Fresh Mint. Winning kids over in the war against plaque and decay.
Tip-top multi-grains, yummy. Yeah, it tastes just like white bread does.
How do they get the grainy bits so soft?
They hit them with a hammer, I expect.
No. Mum, are they for us?
Tip-top multi-grain. White bread taste and the goodness of pre-softened grains. No wonder kids voted number one.
Good on your mum. Tip-top's the one. Good on your mum.
I reckon an elephant sits on them.
This Wednesday, Gold Lotto jackpots to an estimated $2 million. A system entry where you cross out 7, 8, 9, up to 20 numbers in a single game panel gives you a lot more chances to win more. Think about it. Would $2 million make a difference?
There's a $1 million difference when you win.
Get your entries in.
Kennedy, one of the greatest political figures of our time.
Ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country.
President and victim of the assassin's bullet, all predicted by Nostradamus.
The great man falls by lightning in the day, an evil foretold by the postulant one. According to the forecast, another falls in the hours of the night.
Here we have the assassinations of Robert and John Kennedy, both predicted in the one quatrain. Also, the suggestion that a modern-day prophet would predict the event and try to warn the men.
An evil foretold by the postulant one.
Gene Dixon publicly foretold the assassination of President Kennedy 11 years beforehand in 1952.
And I remember that day of August 1952. It was pouring down rain just as it was when you came. And I felt this presence so close to me, very close to me. As I went to the St. Matthew's, was kneeling in prayer in front of the Holy Mother, there it showed me as though it was a film, everything that would happen. And it even showed me that the president would be seated, he'd be Democrat, and assassinated in his first term. Now, that was a revelation, that was a prophecy, that would not change.
Well, it's interesting that Gene Dixon like Nostradamus, used a trance method of seeing into the future.
But then, when I got the name of the assassin, that it would be a plot, that was a prediction. That was picking up the thoughts. It's like when you turn on radio or television and pick up a certain channel. So I picked up the channel and got the name of Oswald, and that's documented before it happened. And as I recall, I tried many ways to get to the president. And I thought, well, the best way and the easiest way was to go to Kay Halley. Kay Halley was a very, very close friend of the president's. In fact, knew the father long before Jack was born. And I asked her, would she go to the White House and intercede for me and ask the president not to go to the Southwest? And his trip had not been announced publicly. She said, Jean, what trip? I said, Kay, it's a trip to the Southwest, to Texas. And she promised to go to the White House and intercede for me, and she did go.
Just as Jean Dixon's warning was ignored, so too was that of Nostradamus, even though in Quatrain 37 of the 6th century, he writes with incredible detail of the controversy that would arise over who was actually guilty.
The ancient work will be accomplished. From the roof, evil ruin shall fall onto the great man. Being dead, they will accuse an innocent of the deed, the guilty one hidden in the misty woods.
Lee Harvey Oswald was arrested for the murder of President Kennedy and was himself assassinated before trial.
This is the basement floor of the Dallas City Hall, and that's a scuffle on the basement floor. It seems concerned the part of it.
He has been shot.
It was initially accepted that he was the only one responsible, but new evidence has not only suggested that others were involved, but indeed that Oswald himself might not have fired the fatal shot.
Being dead, they will accuse an innocent of the deed.
Oswald was reported to have shot Kennedy in the back from the sixth story of this building. But two bullets hit the president. One was from behind, but the second, the fatal shot, clearly came from the front, as can be seen from this 8mm film. The only possible position for an assassin to be concealed in front of the car at that moment was this clump of bushes known as the Grassy Knoll. It is believed that this film actually shows the outline of a man and a rifle, here arrowed, concealed in the bushes. And Nostradamus says,
the guilty one hidden in the misty woods.
Much controversy still surrounds the now infamous Warren Report. Accusations of guilt have come from all levels, and many strange events have occurred since. Many questions have remained unanswered, but the one thing that does seem certain is that Nostradamus obviously had an incredible insight into what really happened.
According to the forecast, another falls in the hours of the night.
Robert Kennedy was assassinated on the night of June the 5th, 1968. And here again, Nostradamus refers to a warning of the event.
And I was asked, would Robert Kennedy win the election? Will he be our next president? My reply was no, that Senator Robert Kennedy will never be president of the United States unless he withdraws his candidacy and does not run again until 1976, because 1976 is his timing. That he's rushing it, and that he would be assassinated, and I said it would be right here in this room. I said he would be carried away in his own blood.
We saw wrong and tried to right it, saw suffering and tried to heal it, saw war and tried to stop it. Those of us who loved him and who take him to his rest today pray that what he was to us, what he wished for others, will someday come to pass for all the world.
But does it stop with two brothers? There is a third Kennedy. In several quatrains, Nostradamus writes about three brothers. But there's one in particular in which there's little doubt that he's referring to both John and Edward Kennedy.
The youngest son shall be slandered by a detractor. When enormous and martial deeds shall be done, the least part shall be doubtful to the eldest. and soon after, they shall be equal in government.
Here, Nostradamus is referring to John Kennedy as the eldest and Edward as the youngest.
The youngest son shall be slandered by a detractor.
Senator Edward Kennedy was placed in a very embarrassing and slanderous position over the drowning of Mary Jo Kopechne in July 1969.
There were several developments in the Kennedy accident today. Among them, Police Chief Dominic Arena asked the district court to file a complaint against the senator, charging him with leaving the scene of an accident and failing to report it within a reasonable time. According to a statement given to police by Kennedy, he was heading for a ferry to the mainland with Mary Jo Kopechne, a former secretary to the late Robert Kennedy, and she was a passenger. Kennedy said he took the wrong turn, and his car went off a narrow bridge into 8 feet of water. Kennedy managed to escape, but Miss Kopechne drowned. According to police, 8 hours elapsed from the time of the accident until he showed up at the police station to report it.
When enormous and martial deeds shall be done, the least part shall be doubtful to the eldest.
Many people were very doubtful of President John Kennedy's stand in the Cuban crisis, and particularly over the infamous Bay of Pigs incident.
En Guantánamo, un descarado. Y hoy evacuamos los familiares de los militares ahí.
It shall be the policy of this nation to regard any nuclear missile launched from Cuba against any nation in the Western Hemisphere as an attack by the Soviet Union on the United States, requiring a full retaliatory response upon the Soviet Union.
Fortunately, a world war was avoided, and John Kennedy proved the value of his decision, which brings us to the last line of the quatrain.
And soon after, they shall both be equal in government.
This suggests that Edward will be equal to his brother John in government, that Edward Kennedy will be president of the United States of America.
Well, 10 years ago, there was a chance. Today, it seems most unlikely. Perhaps Nostradamus could be wrong, or maybe it's our interpretation. But then, who knows? Perhaps some unexpected twist still awaits us.
Virago for men.
You're looking at the fastest pie ever invented. Wedgwood's Micro Ease Pies. Meat, chicken, and steak and onion. All with a special pack to keep them crisp in a microwave oven. Wedgwood's Micro Ease Pies. Meat, chicken, and steak and onion. The fastest pies in the universe.
If red's not your colour, don't worry. Katie's new $29 colour collection has purple and blue, green and orange, and pink and yellow. In fact, Katie's new colour collection has almost every colour under the sun. If you dare to wear it, you'll find Katie's colour collection is priced at a very reasonable $29 each. Now that won't make you see red.
You're clever at Katie!
Thank you.
popes and the Catholic Church play a prominent part in the writings of Nostradamus, and there is no doubt that he makes a great appearance of being a devout believer. But there is a counter-suggestion that he was, in fact, masquerading as a Catholic to avoid the persecution and bigotry of the times.
I think a lot of this was done to placate the authorities and allow the book to be published, because you must remember that in long before the book came out, in 1540-odd, he made a remark at some dinner party that he was attending, and he was then chased by the Inquisition and asked to attend them at Toulouse for, in fact, a summary trial. He then ran to Italy and stayed there for 10 years till it calmed down. And once you were wanted by the Inquisition, you didn't take that thing like that lightly.
Doris Collins, noted English medium, claims to have actually made contact with Nostradamus, who said on this matter,
I was born a Jew. And although I changed my religion, it did not alter the fact that I was born a Jew.
Well, it's a debatable point, about which we may never be sure, but there's little doubt over his predictions concerning the Catholic Church in general. In fact, there were quite a few of them, and had they been easier to interpret, Nostradamus would have run headlong into the trouble he took such pains to avoid.
Through the death of the very old Pope will be elected a Roman of good age. It will be said of him that he dishonors the Holy Seat, but he will hold it long and with fierce courage.
The very old Pope could be Pius XI, who died at the age of 82 years. His successor to the throne in 1939 was Pius XII.
A Roman of good age.
Pius XII was 63 when elected. The reference made by Nostradamus to his dishonoring the Holy Seat may suggest the opinion of many that the Pope's association with Mussolini and Hitler during World War II, when he did not stand against the Nazi atrocities, brought the papacy into disrepute.
But he will hold it long and with fierce courage.
But after the war, the reputation of Pius was restored by his leadership and his long reign. From 1939 to 1958, a total of 19 years.
19 years, one of the longest reigns in church history. In stark contrast, we recently had a pope whose reign was amongst the shortest. That was Pope John Paul I, a reign of only 5 weeks. His sudden, unexpected death was not only a great shock to the church and the world, but a source of mystery, controversy, and speculation. Although it was officially announced that the Pope had died a natural death, several questions have been raised. Questions which could relate directly to one of the quatrains, in which Nostradamus states that a Pope will be poisoned.
When the tomb of the great Roman is found, a Pope will be elected the next day. He will not be approved of by the Senate. Poisoned, his blood in the sacred chalice.
The tomb of St. Peter was finally consecrated in St. Peter's Basilica during the reign of Paul VI. When he died in 1978, the next pope elected was John Paul I.
A pope will be elected the next day. He will not be approved of by the Senate.
The head of the world's most powerful church, new to his office, has turned out to be quite a different man from what his electors imagined.
He has shown himself to be conservative, staunchly and outspokenly anti-communist, and seems prepared to impose much more discipline on his clergy.
One night, he meets a series of cardinals, dines with two others, and sees two more before retiring. The following morning, he is found dead in his bed.
The brief official announcement says he died of a heart attack. As far as anyone knows, he had been in perfect health.
There is no autopsy. Church rules imply that there should not be. And the city's two most prominent embalmers are quickly whisked by limousine to the bedside to perform their task, obliterating forever the cause of death and leaving the question of who done it buried in the Byzantine workings of the church.
He that shall be covered with a great cloak shall be induced to commit some great act. The 12 red ones shall soil the tablecloth. Under murder, murder shall be committed.
The 12 red ones. Well, we know that Pope John Paul dined with cardinals on the night of his death. But According to Nostradamus, John Paul I is not the only modern-day pope to have a short reign. In another quatrain, he suggests that other future popes will reign only for short periods.
After the see has been held 17 years, five shall change within the same period of time.
The suggestion here is quite simple and straightforward. It means that during a period of 17 years, we will have five different popes. But when will this occur? Well, history shows us that since the time of Nostradamus, we haven't had five popes in 17 years. So we must look to recent times to see if they fulfill the conditions. Now, Pius XII reigned for 19 years. Perhaps he is a starting point, even though his reign was 2 years longer than Nostradamus stipulated. Of course, it must in all fairness be pointed out that to be 2 years out after 400 years seems a reasonable error. However, as Pius XII was succeeded by John the 23rd for 5 years and Paul the 6th for 15 years, this can't be right, because the reign of these two popes alone totals 20 years. So, our pope of 17 years can't be Pius XII. But perhaps it could be Paul the 6th. His reign was 15 years. Again, an error of two, as pointed out before. But before we investigate this, we must first turn to another prophet who lived before Nostradamus and who wrote exclusively about the popes. His name was Malachy.
Saint Malachy, an Irish bishop of the 12th century, devoted his visionary powers to the future of the Roman popes. He predicted 112 popes from the year 1143, using symbolic and characteristic titles to describe each pope. According to St. Malachy, our present pope, John Paul II, is pope number 110. Pope 111 is described as Olive's glory, and pope number 112, Peter the Roman, the last of St. Malachy's popes. He writes, "During the last persecution of the Holy Roman Church will reign Peter the Roman, who will tend his sheep amidst numerous tribulations. These having passed, the city of Seven Hills will be destroyed, and the stern judge will judge his people."
Now we have a chance to look into the future of the Catholic Church and Rome. Knowing that St. Malachy has said there will be 112 popes, and John Paul II is number 110, then in his theory, there are to be only two more popes of Rome, the last to be called Peter, and the other, well, we're not sure. Now, let's see how this compares to Nostradamus. He says not that the popes will end, but that they will have to leave Rome because Rome is devastated, and he gives us a hint of the time this will occur. If the pope who reigns for 17 years was Paul VI, then he will be followed by five more within the same period. One, John Paul I for 5 weeks. Two, John Paul II. Three, well, we're not quite sure. Four, St. Malachy's last pope of Rome, Peter. Five, another pope, but not in Rome. And that pope will be elected within 17 years from 1978. That is, by the year 1995. Now, I quote Century 3, Quatrain 84. "The great city will soon be quite deserted. Not a single one of the inhabitants will remain. Wall, sex, church and virgin, ravished." And in Century 2, Quatrain 41, he writes, "The cloud will make the sun appear double. Witnesses to an atomic explosion have described the blast as appearing like a second sun. The large mastiff, the dogs of war, will howl all night when the great pontiff changes his abode." These two quatrains clearly describe the destruction of Rome, probably by a nuclear blast. And if we refer to the figures acquired earlier, it seems safe to assume that sometime around the year 1995, the pope will have to leave Rome because the great city is devastated by an atomic bomb.
Thank you.
you want to buy a car and you don't know where to go, you go to Nissan Best Buy. They're a brand new show. Walk this way. Listen to what I say. You got your car home and you change your mind. You'd like another car, but you've already signed. Well, these are radical guys. And to prove that's true, then 5 days of buying, they'll exchange it for you. Let's dash. The best used car, only one place to get her. Nissan Best Buys, no one helps you better. Walk.
Break out of your old routine.
Use a separate shampoo and conditioner? Why bother? Now there's Pert, the first shampoo and complete conditioner in one.
Got too much you're busy doing to fuss around with your shampoo. And now you have a shampoo that conditions too. Just wash and go with Pert.
Have beautiful hair in just one step. Who needs a separate shampoo and conditioner? Pert 2-in-1 is a breakthrough.
Just wash and go with Pert.
For the last 50 years, more fathers like Jack have enjoyed the Phillishave Edge than any other shaver. Now, for Father's Day, Phillishave gives you even more to enjoy. Because when you buy a selected Phillishave bestseller, we'll give you two more bestsellers free.
Going up?
The Phillishave Father's Day. Take a closer look.
Give me your hand.
Oh, Peter.
That's great.
Oh, what did you think? A lot of women you see on TV have my hands. I'm a professional hand model. These are my living. So when I put them in washing up water, I want a mild formula. Palmolive. Nothing gets dishes cleaner, but it's still really mild on my hands. Every little bit helps.
Palmolive. Mild on hands.
Here's a beautiful idea. Buy September Home Beautiful and you'll get this free copy of Epicurean magazine, packed with superb features and tempting recipes. Also in September Home Beautiful, we visit Leray Desmond at home. There's the latest looks in fabrics and your chance to win a decor update. We reveal 20 top decor tricks, plus super ideas in home extensions. All this and a free copy of Epicurean magazine. September Home Beautiful, full of good ideas for better living. Out now.
A young man returns to Wandon Valley.
Welcome home.
Hi, Dad.
The victim of renal failure.
It's a kidney malfunction.
He needs your help, Ted. That's why he's come home.
I thought I had the flu.
A father's anxiety.
Came up to be a man, he came back a cripple.
And frustration waiting for a donor.
The Australian medical system just can't deliver the goods.
I'm not even going to try to debate that with you, Ted.
A typical parent fighting for their child's life.
Dad, there's nothing you can do.
Don't you bet on it.
Can a father buy his son's health? A Country Practice, 7:30 Monday on 7.
Occupy a new land around Syria, Judea, and Palestine.
In this quatrain, we have another example of the very specific detail Nostradamus was able to give. Here, he very clearly describes the creation of the Israeli state, actually naming the countries involved.
Around Syria, Judea, and Palestine.
And he refers to the ongoing struggle that arose over the newly claimed land.
Newcomers will build a place without defenses, occupying the place till then uninhabitable.
Israel reclaimed large areas of desert and swamp under its kibbutz program, making it both highly productive and attractive to marauders.
Meadows, houses, fields, towns to be taken at will, famine, plague, war, land long arable.
And he goes on to suggest that war in this area will continue until the end of this, our 20th century.
The great barbarian empire will crumble before the century of the sun is finished.
Another striking quatrain relevant to our times.
Rain, famine, war in Persia having not ceased. Too great a fate shall betray the monarch. Being ended there, it shall commence in France. The secret omen to one that he should die.
This is a startling prediction, giving outstanding detail of the war in Persia, the ancient name for Iran. But let us examine it carefully.
Too great a faith will betray the monarch.
The resurgent Islamic faith was the basis for the overthrow of the Iranian monarchy.
Being ended there, it will commence in France.
The political and cultural revolution in Iran was fathered by its spiritual leader, the Ayatollah Khomeini,
who directed his coup from exile in France. His triumphant return to Iran saw him established as the undisputed leader of his country and symbol of the resurgence in fundamentalist Islam.
Incredible how our perspective changes. Then, Khomeini was a new word. Today we add words like glasnost, ozone layer, and AIDS to our vocabulary. Much has happened in these last 10 years. We now think in terms of global problems, of a dying planet, of a modern-day plague. Things that once we thought were science fiction are now science fact. So, of these enormous events of the 80s, just how much did Nostradamus see?
It's not a time for denunciation, but for reconciliation.
The day that she is saluted by the Queen, the day after the salute, the request. The account makes sense and value. Previously humble, never a woman so proud.
Here, it seems, Nostradamus is describing Britain's first woman Prime Minister, Margaret Thatcher.
The day after the salute, the request.
Almost immediately on taking office, Mrs. Thatcher introduced stern measures to rescue the economy, asking the people to make sacrifices and suffer personal hardships for the overall good of the nation.
The account makes sense and value.
The British economy has certainly improved, and many other world leaders are now adopting some of her tactics.
I think we've done reasonably well.
Born the daughter of a grocer, Margaret Thatcher is now one of the most powerful women in the world and commands immense respect. Dubbed the Iron Lady, she is a woman of apparently unshakable pride and almost regal bearing.
We have become a grandmother.
Previously humble, never a woman so proud. In the year that Saturn and Mars are equally fiery, the air is very dry, a long meteor. From secret fires, a great place burns with heat. Little rain, hot wind.
Here, Nostradamus is suggesting that the appearance of a comet will coincide with some type of disaster involving fire. 1986 was the year that Halley's Comet reappeared in our skies. And in April of that year, the world learned of a disastrous nuclear accident at Chernobyl in the Soviet Union.
From secret fires, a great place burns with heat.
Despite an explosion and enormous fire in one of its nuclear reactors, the Soviet Union attempted to keep the Chernobyl disaster secret. Although there was massive radiation leakage, news only got out when the Soviets had to call on foreign help to control the raging fire.
Little rain, hot wind.
As winds carried the contamination across Europe, threatening the entire world, the secret of Chernobyl became very much a public concern.
So great a plague will come with the great shell.
It seems that Nostradamus very clearly saw today's great plague, AIDS. His reference to a shell appropriately describes the AIDS virus.
Heaven weeps too much over the birth of the androgyn.
Androgyn, meaning having the characteristics of both sexes, is again most appropriate when we consider that the AIDS disease was initially associated with homosexuality. Today, it is spreading through our community, potentially affecting millions.
By death, too late for the great people to be revived. Soon, but late, comes the awaited help.
Nostradamus suggests that a cure will be found, but it will obviously be too late for many.
The great carpet folded will not show even a half of the greater part of its history.
The AIDS quilt, with each square representing a victim, but, as Nostradamus says, only a fraction of the true toll.
Driven far away, it will appear harsh, but everyone will come to believe in a warlike deed.
He also sees fear of AIDS causing sufferers to become outcasts in the face of public hysteria.
Liftoff of the 25th space shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
Nine will be set apart from the human flock. separated from judgment and advice. Their fate is to be divided as they depart. Kappa, Theta, Lambda, dead, banished, and scattered.
Although there are only seven astronauts on board, the remainder of this quatrain very specifically relates to the tragic explosion of the U.S. space shuttle Challenger and is an outstanding example of Nostradamus' uncanny insight.
The last line of the quatrain was very confusing because it had three Greek letters in it. TH, which is a letter, a Greek letter, K and L. And I was looking at these letters and I couldn't think, I mean, it's such an unusual combination of letters, I couldn't think of anything at all that could relate to. And then just by chance I was reading about the government report on Challenger, and the blame for the disaster was laid on the manufacturers of the rocket components, the seals, and that was a company called Morton Thiokol, which is T-H-I-O-K-O-L. So it was the four main consonants were there in the quatrain.
Kappa, Theta, Lambda, dead, vanished, and scattered.
Incredible, really. Frightening, like we said, to think that 400 years ago, a man could write with such detail and clarity. Yet, if you were to ask how many of those events from the 80s did we include as predictions in our first program, the answer would be none. We didn't see any of them. Nostradamus did. They were all there in his writings, but none of us had the foresight to recognize them.
There's no doubt that it's so much easier to understand what he's talking about when you've got the benefit of hindsight, when you can look at an event and look at a quatrain and very clearly see what it was he was trying to say. But when it comes to future events, well, we think you've got to be really careful.
I think the problem is that there are people who have looked at Nostradamus and they've gone for the extreme. They've gone for believing everything or finding a meaning for everything and relating it to some aspect in history, in some cases twisting it and distorting it, and we think being very irresponsible in doing that. The important thing that we feel is that you have to, if in doubt, leave it out, is basically it. You've got to have the greatest degree of care if you're going to have any credibility at all with something like this. It's very easy to twist it. I mean, there are people who might even just change a word in the French or something like that. And that one letter change can make a huge difference to the meaning.
Some of his quatrains are really very complex and they're really best left alone. But some of them, you can get a bit of an inkling into what it is he's trying to say or you think he's saying. Enough to realise that that event hasn't yet happened. And so it's probably associated with our future. There was an example of that which we did include in the first program, which is in fact happening right now, and that's the decline of communism.
The Moorish law will be seen to fail, followed by another that is more pleasing. Boris Danes will be the first to give way through gifts and tongues to another more appealing.
This reference to Moorish law is intriguing because some 10 years before Nostradamus first began his writings, Sir Thomas More published his famous Utopia, the great formula for the perfect but imaginary state. Obviously, Nostradamus would be familiar with the work, but what is intriguing is that he should predict that the Utopia, More's law, would become the basis for a new and revolutionary system of government in the 20th century, communism. And further than that, to suggest that it will ultimately weaken and fail.
Nobody knows Brisbane like Seven. Seven Nightly News knows Brisbane. Nobody knows Brisbane like Seven. Seven Nightly News knows Brisbane. Nobody knows Brisbane like Seven.
Oh.
Look what Big W got for Dad. Bond's Grand Slam shirts in heaps of colours. Snap them up for just $15.97. The club steering lock, $49.86. Our low price every day. Plus lots more for Dad on Father's Day at Big W now.
Tip Top Multigrain's yummy. Yeah, it tastes just like white bread does.
How did I get the grainy bits so soft?
They hit them with a hammer, I expect.
No.
Mum, are they for us?
Tip Top Multigrain. White bread taste and the goodness of pre-softened grains. No wonder kids voted number one.
Good on your mum. Tip Top's the one. Good on your mum.
I reckon an elephant sits on them.
Across the street, across the world, they call on you.
Grace Removals, for removals or storage.
But it was in the way your special care. On the day, I'd have to say, the best moves are made with Grace. The best moves are made, the best moves are made with Grace.
If you've ever been overcooked, underarmed,
or greased and oiled.
If you've ever been spotty dogged, sticky bunned,
or just plain soiled,
well, when the day is over, and mostly over you,
I've just been moosed.
Then there's one thing to unstain you. You've got to rinse stains clean before you machine.
Now that's green clean.
Rinse stains clean before you machine.
Change you make.
Making me some changes.
Come on, Mum, get out of the pantry.
Not even in your wildest dreams could you imagine a better range of new designer kitchens. The Live-In Kitchen Collection. Craftsman-made dream kitchens on display 7 days a week, exclusively at Mad Barry's. So you won't lose sleep over the prices either.
Boris Danes will be the first to give way through gifts and tongues to another more appealing.
That could mean the end of communism. There is a reference to the river Boris Danes, which is the Dnieper. In southern Russia, it says that Boris Danes will fail. That means Dnieper will fail first. Respectively, the southern Russia will fall first.
The Soviet Union, long the bastion of communism, but lately we've seen southern Russia, scene of pro-democracy demonstrations. The Balkan states, independence movements, Moscow, home of Glasnost, and spreading to Poland and Eastern Europe, more calls for democracy. And finally, the tragedy of China.
From early evening onwards, that this was to be the decisive night.
Those assembled through the calm of the great number, by land and sea, council countermanded. Near the autumn, people, shadow of cloud, revolution against the leader through fields and towns. The Republic of the Great City will not want to consent to severe repression. The ladder at the wall, the city to repent. The old will hold strong, then removed from the scene.
At 54, Mikhail Gorbachev was a complete contrast to the previous old Soviet rulers. Youthful and reformist, he symbolizes a new generation of Soviet thinking.
It is obvious, for example, that the use or threat of force can no longer and must no longer be an instrument of foreign policy.
The old will hold strong, then removed from the scene. Then all things common among friends put far behind.
All things common among friends, the main theme of communism,
so aptly described by Nostradamus, is to be put far behind. It all seemed so far-fetched then, but now we read more about it daily. And this is one of the most intriguing aspects about reconsidering these prophecies right now. Whereas before we had a well-defined past and future, this time the future is closely interwoven with the present. Many of Nostradamus's quatrains relate to things we're experiencing right now. And so we're able to more easily recognize at least some aspects of his veiled message. Religious wars, a spread of Islam, continuing natural disasters, all of these are there. And with them, the realization that what we thought was so far off in the future now has actually started. So now, the future. What does Nostradamus tell us will happen? Essentially, the prediction is war. A third world war that will be nuclear and far worse than all other wars put together.
One that shall force the infernal gods of Hannibal to live again, the terror of mankind. Never more horror, nor the papers tell of worse in the past. And in the last era, all the kingdoms of Christianity and also all unbelievers shall quake for the space of years, and there shall be more grievous wars and battles. Towns, cities, castles, and other buildings shall be burnt, desolated, and destroyed. Married women and widows ravished, sucking children dashed against the walls of towns, and so many evils shall be committed by the means of that infernal prince, Satan, that almost the entire world shall be undone and desolate.
To have a war, you must have aggression. Where will it come from? Russia? China? The West? In quatrain after quatrain, Nostradamus indicates that the trouble will come from the Middle East, specifically Iran, or, as it was called in his day, Persia.
By fire and sword, not far from the Black Sea, they shall come from Persia to seize upon Trebizond. The kingdoms of the church will be overcome by the sea, towards Persia, very near a million. Help provided too late, Persia will turn and invade Macedonia. France by neglect shall be assaulted by five sides. Tunis and Algiers shall be stirred by the Persians.
There are too many references to ignore the suggestion that the Middle East will play a central role in the trouble to come. And yet, is this a realistic possibility? Could Persia, or Iran as we know it, cause a third world war? To answer this, let's turn to what we know of Iran today and the revival of Islam throughout the world.
In some ways, then, 10 years ago, to talk about Islam and the Middle East being the sort of central focal point of a war that develops into a world war scale was a little bit hard to believe, you know. Whereas now, that's one of the difficulties, if you like, because whereas before we could just say there's going to be a third world war, it's going to happen then and it's going to involve these people. Now when we say those things, it's so real that it needs a little bit more support. And what we've had to do is look a lot more deeply into the quatrains of Nostradamus to see if he gives it more support, to see if he's consistent about what he says.
The great Arab will march well. From the Orient will come the African heart to trouble. Accompanied by the Libyan fleet, the man from the East will come out of his seat and will cross the Apennines. The country of Greater Arabia shall be born. Sardinia is vexed by the African fleet.
One thing we can see is that it is not just Iran that Nostradamus sees as the main protagonist in this future conflict. He uses many different phrases to suggest that several countries of the Middle East will be involved in this war. A war that he very clearly states will be religious, and more specifically, Muslim versus Christian.
The Church of God will be persecuted, and the holy temples will be pillaged. The kingdoms of the church will be overcome by the sea. Towards Persia, very near a million.
The religious factor is extremely important in the whole Middle East. It's the cradle of the world's great religions. The you know, predominance of Islam since its onset in the 7th century, the split in the world of Islam, which we saw erupting in the Gulf War during the 1980s, which we see as an important factor in Lebanon. In this world of Islam, of course, from time to time, non-Islamic communities have had great difficulty surviving. Other times they have survived, they've even flourished in the history of the Islamic Middle East. Obviously the Christian community of Lebanon, like the Jewish community of Israel, do have serious problems predicated on the religious factor.
O great Rome, your ruin draws near, not of your walls, but of your blood and substance. Mahomet against you, more so the Adriatic, you will gnaw the bones of horses and asses. Because of French discord and negligence, an opening shall be given to the Mohammedans. Mohammedan increase, and the herald is sent to call out for surrender.
His constant reference to Mohammedans suggests that Nostradamus sees the Middle East united under a common bond, Islam.
There are specific doctrinal differences, but at the same time, while they have a different history, different sociology, the fundamental theology does unite the world of Islam.
Out of the country of Greater Arabia shall be born a strong master of Mohammedan law, who shall vex Spain and conquer Granada, and by sea shall come to the Italian nation.
Next on Hinch.
Westerns were a thing of the past, but we're about to witness the rebirth of the Hollywood hero, the cowboy.
Hey, camera Mark.
Well, Woodrow.
Behind the scenes as Lonesome Dove becomes a Hollywood epic. Next on Hinch.
Can you show me how to bake a perfect cake?
Gladly.
Gladly.
Can you show me how to stoke this kitchen mess?
Gladly.
Gladly.
Can you show me how to cook a whole baked fish?
How to freeze things in a baking dish? Make the microwave do what I wish.
Gladly.
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 I'll do it gladly.
Can you show me how to keep the garbage?
Gladly.
Gladly.
Can you show me where to dump this garden junk?
Gladly.
Announcing a dramatic breakthrough in shaving technology, the Remington Microscreen Ultimate.
Shaves as close as a blade, or I'll give you your money back.
The Ultimate's exclusive beard lifter gets whiskers other shavers leave behind. And like all Remington Microscreen shavers, the first screen shaves incredibly close, the second even closer. The Remington Microscreen Ultimate.
Shaves as close as a blade, or I'll give you your money back. And the Lady Remington, the perfect gift.
We're getting older. The baby boomers are in their 40s now. Retirement couples have thronged to Queensland. Fewer babies are being born. This means we will soon have a greater proportion of older people in our community. And we need to take advantage of their skills and experience and understand their special needs. When you get your copy of this Queensland Government questionnaire and policy statement on the aging, please read it carefully and get involved.
Good Start, the tastiest energy breakfast. Good Start from Sanitarium, simply the finest breakfast cereal money can buy.
Have a great day.
You can't beat the wool store on selection. Over 5 acres of manufacturer displays under one roof in New Farm. You can't beat the wool store on lounges. Over 1,000 on permanent display. Save $340 on this matching lounge chair and sofa bed. You can't beat the wool store on quality. Save $1,000 on this elegant leather import from Italy. You can't beat the wool store, because only with us can you buy direct from over 290 manufacturer displays. The unbeatable wool store. Open till 9 Friday, all day Saturday.
Can you show me how to stove this kitchen mess?
Gladly.
Gladly.
Glad handle tie bags.
Tear them off, tip it in, and tie them off. Deodorize too. That'll make you glad.
I'll do it gladly.
I told you, exciting things were coming.
5:30 Monday, there's big news on Wheel of Fortune.
Are we going up market or what?
Only on 7.
The man from the east will come out of his seat and will cross the Apennines to see France. He will cross through the sky, the seas and the snows, and he will strike everyone with his rod.
Perhaps we should realize at this stage that some of the content of this program may be disturbing and upsetting to some. But it must be remembered, we're dealing with prophecy, and it should be viewed as such. The thoughts expressed in this program do not reflect the beliefs of the producers or the station, or even myself, for that matter. They're statements based solely on the translation and interpretation of the writings of Nostradamus. Now, surely, any clues to the reality of a Third World War must be worth considering. For Nostradamus does give us this hope. We can change our destiny. And to help, he gives us some very definite clues as to the timing of this war.
In the year 1999 and 7 months, from the sky will come the great king of terror. He will bring back to life the great king of the Mongols. Before and after, war reigns happily.
1999 and 7 months is specific, and yet elsewhere he also tells us that the barbaric empire will crumble before the end of the century of the sun. And that's our century, the 20th century. So a war that starts and lasts only 5 months is obviously not what we're talking about. No. So what we then had to do was to look for more details.
The third Antichrist is soon annihilated. 27 years of blood his war will last.
It's talking about an overall 27 years, but what we realize this time is that it's not on a worldwide scale for all of that time, because now we can understand that we've got wars happening all around us in the world that are going on for very, very lengthy periods of time, you know. And so we can start to comprehend that what Nostradamus was talking about is potentially a war like that. And so what we then had to do was to look further to get an indication of when a war that was 27 years might have started. And to do this, what we needed to find was more specific things related to the ending.
Mars and the scepter will be in conjunction, a calamitous war and the cancer. A short time afterwards, a new king will be anointed who will bring peace to the earth for a long time.
See, it says Mars and the scepter will be in conjunction. If he's talking astrologically, then we'd have to place either the scepter being a fixed star, which probably it's not, because that would happen every 2 years, or a planet. And the scepter probably, I felt, would be Jupiter because of the regality and so on. And Mars-Jupiter would be conjunct in July 2002, around July 3rd and 4th.
So what we were able to do is subtract our 27 years from the 2002 and find that he's talking about 1975. Now, is there something that... There were a lot of wars going on in 1975 already, and there were a lot of them were religious-based. Yeah. But was there one that started somewhere that had a basis of Muslim or Islam against Christianity? And there was. And Lebanon started that civil war that was, you know, Christian and Muslim fighting each other, started in 1975.
Well, there's no doubt that the fundamentalist Islam, as we've seen in the Gulf War itself, as we see in Lebanon, in the activities of the Hezbollah movement, it clearly represents a major concern. And I suppose if one was looking at one of the most disturbing aspects of the of that region, and indeed in the globe, it would have to be the enormous size and battle-hardened nature of the military capacities of some of these radical military dictatorships in the area. The sophistication of the weaponry and the callous, brutal nature of the fighting, using children as mine detectors by the Iranians, for example, and their preparedness to sacrifice tens and tens of thousands of their people in battle. But on the other hand, the Iraqis, with their extremely brutal use of weapons of mass destruction, chemical warfare, poison gas.
Plague, famine, death from military hands, plague through false dust.
If we're talking about chemical warfare, we're talking about enormous chemical disruptions to the atmosphere, and we're worrying about using aerosols, and we shouldn't stop worrying about things like that. But the implications for what chemical warfare could do to things like the ozone layer, the greenhouse effect.
A very great famine caused by a pestilent wave will extend its long reign the length of the Arctic Pole, turning from one way to another and then becoming universal. So great and long that they shall come to pluck the root from the wood and the child from the breast. Rain, blood, famine, war and disease.
It's interesting when you read Nostradamus because he talks about the war will come and he talks about earthquakes and he talks about famine and plague, and they're all sort of thrown in together. And I really think that they're an inevitable result of war. And obviously diseases that happens with war. Obviously also famine can happen.
Furthermore, the world will suffer by so many deluges and by so high floods that there will remain scarcely any land not covered by water.
What even 10 years ago we thought were almost like science fiction things, now we know that they're a reality. I mean, we do know now about environmental changes, for example, that could cause these sorts of cataclysmic type floodings. We know about changes going on with the whole Earth's atmosphere that potentially might even lead to such an extreme as an axis shift.
And it will be in the month of October that a great transformation will occur, and such that one will think the gravity of the Earth has lost its natural movement and has been plunged into the abyss of perpetual darkness.
It's intriguing that Nostradamus should refer so much to these extreme atmospheric conditions, which are so like the dramatic weather changes we're experiencing right now, all over the world. Again, we enter the dimension of present as against future. And he often suggests that these natural events are signs, warning us that the man-made disasters are close at hand. And there is one other area of natural disasters which we're experiencing regularly and to which Nostradamus constantly refers, earthquakes.
A very great trembling in the month of May.
The sun in 20 degrees of Taurus, there will be a great earthquake. The great theater, full up, will be ruined.
Shaking fire from the center of the earth will cause tremors around the new city.
For several nights, the earth will shake.
In our first program, we suggested the possibility of an earthquake in 1988. And due to the instability along the San Andreas fault line, we thought it might be around San Francisco.
It's been determined that the recurrence rate between great earthquakes is about 160 years. The last one was in 1857, that was 122 years ago. So we're getting up into the time period when we have to think about such an occurrence. The plates are still moving and only a certain amount of strain can be held up there. It will happen again.
Although strong tremors are felt regularly in this area, there was not a major earthquake in San Francisco itself in 1988. However, there was a devastating quake in that year, but on the opposite side of the world, Armenia, in southern Russia.
The plans were hopelessly inadequate. As people continued to struggle with little more than their hands to reach trapped relatives and calm freedom, their frustrations turned to bitterness and anger.
Here, it seems his indications of timing were right, but our interpretation of location was wrong. However, for the future, it seems we have the reverse. He gives us no clues as to when, but he's very definite about the place. In two quatrains, he specifically refers to severe earthquakes in Corinth and Ephesus in Greece.
For several nights, the earth will shake. Corinth and Ephesus will swim in the two seas. An earthquake will be reported from the depths of Asia. Both Corinth and Ephesus, then in a troubled state.
Greece, it seems, is to face a major earthquake, but not just natural disasters. Nostradamus also suggests that Greece will be one of many countries to suffer the onslaught of war.
From the Black Sea and Great Tartaria will be a king who will come to see France. He will penetrate through Alania and Armenia, and in Byzantium will leave his bloody rod. He will come from Persia to occupy Trebizond. Ancient roads will come forward to meet him, and greater harm through the other Hungarians. Sun bright, the Adriatic Sea covered with Arab blood. Help provided too late, Persia will turn and invade Macedonia. Turkey, Egypt, true serpent will invade.
He talks about the true serpent, and it's very apt sort of a description, because it's like a very insidious, a very subtle spread that is happening without you really, you're realizing it is going on. And it could quite feasibly be that it's just, is this very subtle spread from the Middle East, say across through Turkey, then Greece, and then via, say, Malta and Sicily, and into Europe.
From the Orient will come the African heart to trouble Hadria and the heirs of Romulus, accompanied by the Libyan fleet. The temples of Malta and nearby islands shall be deserted. Naples, Palermo, and all of Sicily will be uninhabited through barbarian hands. Corsica, Salerno, and the island of Sardinia, hunger, plague, war. From Monaco as far as Sicily, all the coast will remain deserted. There will be no suburbs, cities, nor towns which have not been pillaged and robbed by barbarians.
If you see Middle Eastern countries that are normally Muslim countries anyway, and if you saw major changes going on, even if it was to the extent of the more militant forms of Islam coming in there, the Western world is not going to interfere in that. It's none of their business. Whereas it's only when you start getting over towards the European areas, which are not those Muslim-type countries, that it's feasible then that that's when the reaction could come. But by that time, it's suddenly a very much larger force than it was before. So it becomes a much more major confrontation needed to try and arrest it.
The kingdom of Fez shall come to those of Europe. Fire and sword shall destroy their city. The great one of Asia, by land and sea, with a great army, so that blues, greens, crosses, to death he shall drive. The head of London, with American rule, the island of Scotland tempered with frost. Rebel king will have one so false an antichrist who will put them all into conflict.
I suppose we could consider this as the turning point of this ongoing war. What was previously a series of battles suddenly escalates into worldwide proportions. Why? We don't really know what triggers it, but we do know that it engulfs all of Europe and seems to coincide with our early reference to the Pope leaving Rome around 1995 to 96.
The king enters Foix wearing a blue turban. He will reign for less than a revolution of Saturn. The king with a white turban, his heart banished to Byzantium. Sun, Mars, and Mercury near Aquarius.
Sun, Mars, and Mercury, of course, are very fast moving. And so they, you know, we would see them change signs a lot. So being all in the same sign, you would imagine that that would be quite common. But in looking at dates, certainly the first time that we could place Sun, Mars, and Mercury in Aquarius, looking from now, which is 1989, wasn't until 1996.
1996, potentially a significant date for France. But this quatrain contains more.
And also now we've discovered, too, in the chart of Iran that Sun, Mars, and Mercury are also in Aquarius, and that was 1979. That date would be based on when Khomeini took over from the Shah of Iran.
The fact that this conjunction also occurred when the new Iran was born gives an extra dimension to this quatrain.
The king enters Foix wearing a blue turban.
We know that it was from France that the Ayatollah Khomeini fathered the Islamic Revolution.
He will reign for less than a revolution of Saturn.
The Saturn cycle takes 29 and a half years.
So Nostradamus is suggesting that although the Ayatollah himself is now dead, his regime could have a long life, as much as 29 years. And so continue to be a major force on into the 21st century. Academy Award winner Angelica Houston is Clara Allen.
I think you know so much about women, Gus. But you don't.
Strong enough to walk the line between a man's world.
I love Gus. But I wasn't going to fight you for him every day of my life.
And a woman's desire.
Gus and I were sweethearts once.
A tragic desire that could never be fulfilled.
He wanted what I wouldn't give. I wanted what he didn't have.
Her story begins soon on the 7 Network. Lonesome Dove.
If you're going to move, do what we did. Call Rainbow.
We get around. From the city to the country town.
We get around.
Moving furniture, safe and sound.
Safe and sound.
You're moving out, the house is sold.
We get around.
Don't you know there's a pot of gold?
At the end, depend on a Rainbow.
Rainbow Furniture Transport.
We get around.
Do you dream of going fishing, just hauling in some brim, or putting a veranda on an old Queenslander? Everybody's got a dream. What about retiring early, giving up the sink for the swim? Take a holiday safari, grab a new Ferrari. Everybody's got a dream. Dreaming. Don't stop dreaming. Golden casket, 'cause everybody's got a dream.
Dreaming.
Know what I mean?
Don't stop dreaming.
Golden casket, 'cause everybody's got a dream.
Golden casket, where thousands of dreams are drawn every week.
Everybody's got a dream.
The thing about beef shortcuts is...
It's great, Michael.
Yeah?
They don't look like you've taken any.
Trevor Hendy, world Iron Man champion, is one of Australia's fittest young men. So why does he grab hold of MBF health cover?
No matter how fit you are, you can't guarantee your future health. But with MBF cover, you can guarantee you'll get the best treatment for eyes, teeth, muscles in hospital. MBF cover. Worth grabbing a hold of now.
MBF, first-class treatment every time.
Hello, Michael Hill Jeweler. All my gold and silver chains are drastically reduced for Father's Day. This 9-carat chain, $201, now $89. This solid silver chain, $51, now $19. For quality, selection and value, Michael Hill Jeweler.
Now, Pizza Hut are giving away 1,000 free pizzas every day.
Oh, we've won!
Pizza Hut, making it great!
Win with dine-in, takeaway or home delivery.
Long before these happenings, the people of the East, influenced by the moon in the year 1700, will cause many to be carried away and will almost subdue the northern area. The head of Aries, Jupiter and Saturn. Eternal God, what changes? Then the bad times will return again after a long century. What turmoil in France and Italy.
Nostradamus makes it painfully clear that the latter half of the 1990s will see war of a major scale sweeping across Europe.
I bewail Nice, Monaco, Pisa, Genoa, Savona, Siena, Capua, Modena, Malta. Upon them, blood and sword for a New Year's gift. The great camel will come to drink of the Danube and the Rhine and will not repent of it. Those of the Rhone tremble, and even more so those of the Loire. Spain captive, taken in battle by the Libyan leader, and Roman scepter smitten by the cock. The great ruin of the clergy is not far off. Provence, Naples, Sicily.
In numerous quatrains, Nostradamus reminds us that this is a religious war and that the Catholic Church is very much in the firing line.
The large mastiff will howl all night when the great pontiff changes his abode. The Holy Empire will come to Germany, the Arabs will find open places.
The Pope is forced to leave Rome. However, this too is futile, as the war spills into Germany.
Sees and pontiffs in Germany at the Rhine and Cologne, vexed to death by those of Magance.
And he even specifies Switzerland, traditionally neutral, to be a principal target.
Leave, leave, go forth out of Geneva all. The contrary of the positive ray shall exterminate all.
This could only be a reference to the chain reaction involving positive and negative particles in nuclear fission. Ultimately, the atomic bomb.
Never more horror, nor the papers tell of worse in the past than will come to the Romans through Babylon.
The Islamic bomb scenario, of course, stems from its sophistication in this area. The real problem is when imbalances occur or when these weapons of mass destruction fall in the hands of crazy, irrational actors. And of course, the Middle East has to be looked at in that light, and that is the area of great concern that responsible world leadership really does have to focus on.
At the 48th degree of the climacteric, the end of cancer, there is a very great drought. Fish in the sea, rivers and the lake boiled, hectic. Béarn and Bigorre in distress from fire in the sky. The trembling of the earth at Mortara, the tin island of St. George half sunk. Drowsy with peace, war will arise. Garden of the world near the new city, in the way of the man-made mountains, shall be seized on and plunged into a ferment, being forced to drink sulfurous poisoned waters. The sky will burn at 45 degrees. Fire approaches the great new city. Immediately a huge scattered flame leaps up. Will come, so very horrible that young nor old nor animal will survive.
With such devastation, it almost seems incidental who actually wins. But it seems Nostradamus does see an end due to an alliance between the United States and Russia. Today, this is yet another example of prophecy unfolding in our daily lives. But 10 years ago, it was very hard to imagine.
An alliance between the USA and Russia. Now, this may seem far-fetched, but let's examine the evidence given by Nostradamus.
When those of the Arctic pole shall be united together, there shall be in the east great fear and trembling. One shall be newly elected that shall bear the brunt. Rhodes, Constantinople, shall be dyed with barbarian blood.
Those of the Arctic Pole can only mean Russia and the US. As we see here at the Bering Strait, the two continents are at their closest point in the Arctic Circle. Alaska, part of the US, and Russia. And he goes on to say, in the East, great fear and trembling. So he's suggesting here that these two northern powers will unite against the East. And there's a further quatrain to support this. One day the two great masters shall be friends. Their great powers shall be increased. And incredible as it may seem, Nostradamus suggests that this alliance will not only occur, but will triumph. As he says in several quatrains, and also in one of his epistles.
For the principal eastern ruler, being for the most part moved by the northern and western men, shall be vanquished and put to death, beaten, and all the rest put to flight, and the children he had by many women put in prison. The barbarian league will be driven out. Of the two laws, the pagan one will fail.
Here, he tells us the pagan law will be driven out, and goes on to talk of a king of Europe who eventually becomes a driving force for victory for the West.
As a griffin shall come the king of Europe, accompanied by those of the north. Of reds and whites shall conduct a great troop, and then shall go against the king of Babylon. He will drive out the foreign Arabic nation and return the church to her pristine preeminence. The third Antichrist is soon annihilated. 27 years of blood his war will last. The heretics dead, captive, exiled, blood, human bodies, red water, earth shrunk. From Barcelona, from Genoa and Venice, from Sicily near Monaco united, against the barbarian the fleet shall take her aim, the barbarian shall be driven back. After this war shall have lasted a good while, there shall be a renewed reign of Saturn and a golden age. God the Creator shall say, hearing the affliction of his people, Satan shall be put and tied in the bottom of the deep, and here shall begin an age of universal peace.
It is now 1989, and we're about to enter the last decade of this, our 20th century, the end of the millennium. Regardless of how much you believe Nostradamus, hearing his words simply reminds us that this decade has the potential to be the most volatile in our entire history. We all hope these things won't happen, that we'll look back and say Nostradamus was wrong, and maybe he will be. But we are at the crossroads, and the future is ours to shape. It may not be too late. Good night.
Majesty and romance of the Wild West comes to television with Channel 7's Lonesome Dove, a sweeping tale of friendship, courage, and love. Based on the Pulitzer Prize-winning novel, directed by Australia's Simon Windsor, it's the television event of the year. Lonesome Dove, coming soon over four big nights on 7. Lonesome Dove, the Western is back.